thank you very much. Congratulations to everybody who's marched today. It's not the first time that the Kurds have had to march in London, had to sit down in green lanes. In the last few months, there's been the hunger strikes, there's been the Lobotskin massacre, and now there's been the latest three murders in Paris. Let's be clear, these three murders in Paris were terrorism, this was state terrorism.
Bugünkü yürüyüşten dolayı hepinizi kutluyorum. Tabii ki Kürt halkının bugün yürümesi ilk değildi. Kürt halkı Roboski katliamı döneminde yine cezaevlerinde sürdürülen direnişte açlık grevlerinden dolayı Green Lanes üzerinde defalarca yürümek zorunda kaldı.
We're always being told that this is a world where we're going to get human rights. Apparently, capitalism and imperialism are going to give us human rights. But that's not the experience of people around the world. It's not the experience of the Kurds. The fact is that the Kurds, like all of us, should have language rights, should have cultural rights, should have democratic rights, and should have national rights. The Kurds should be able to enjoy those rights in Kurdistan as well as anywhere else.
Katliam, biraz önce unutmuştum, katliamın kendisi terörizm değil, devlet terörizminin kendisidir ifadesini kullanmıştı. Bugün kapitalizm, emperyalizm halklara eşitliği getirmiyor. Emperyalizm ve kapitalizmin tüm dayatmalarına karşı tüm halkların olduğu gibi Kürt halkının da kendi kültürünü, kendi dilini ve kendi özgürlüğünü yaşama hakkı vardır.
Freedom for Öcalan, victory to the Kurds.
Öcalan ve özgürlük Kürdistan'a zafer.
But now I want to talk about how Turkey gets away with it. How does Turkey get away with oppressing the Kurds? How does Turkey get away with killing and murdering the Kurds? I think it's because Turkey has British support by the British government and has support from the USA, US imperialism. Now, Erdogan bashes the Kurds, oppresses the Kurds within Turkey. Erdogan now is going to oppress the Kurds in Syria. Look what happened in Syrakarnia. It's disgraceful and it's disgusting that this is taking place, but it's taking place with American and British support, and that's what we have to do something about.
Peki bu katliamları yaptıktan sonra Türkiye bu katliamlardan nasıl kurtuluyor? Türkiye'nin kurtuluşu ABD'nin, İngiltere'nin ve ABD'nin geniş anlamda kendisine vermiş olduğu destekle oluyor. Bugün Türkiye'de Kürt halkına baktığımızda, Suriye'deki gelişmelere baktığımızda, bölgedeki gelişmelere baktığımızda bu devletlerin saldırgan politikalarıyla Türk devletine destek sundukları çok açık.
The task that we need to have in 2013 for the socialist movement, for the democratic movement in Britain is to deliver some solidarity for the Kurds. We need to have a situation where there are trade union banners and community groups going on the Kurdish demonstrations when they're called. We need to be telling our government that it needs to be stopped supporting Turkey and start supporting the Kurds.
Bu ülkedeki demokratik ve sosyalistlerin, sendikacıların temel görevi, 2013'teki temel görevi Kürt halkının istemlerine ve arzularına, taleplerine desteği arttırmak olmalıdır.
Now, in the world at the moment, the people struggling for their freedom are still fighting and still being oppressed. That's what's happening to the Kurds, that's what's happening to the Tamils, that's what's happening to all of us. Also, people are coming up against fascism. For example, we've seen the rise of fascism in countries like Greece that are worst affected by the economic crisis.
Bugün dünyamızda insanlar, halklar eziliyor, katlediliyor. Dünyamızda faşizm yeniden hortluyor. Bugün Yunanistan'a ve benzeri ülkelere baktığımızda faşizmin, faşist hareketin güçlendiğini görüyoruz.
Let's link together the struggle of the Kurds. Let's link together the struggle for justice with the fight against fascism. There's going to be a demonstration next Saturday at 12 noon outside the Greek embassy to oppose fascism in Greece and fascism in Europe. I invite everybody here to come along. Let's see some Turkish, some Kurdish banners. Let's see some solidarity banners at that demonstration.
Gün Kürt halkının taleplerine sahip çıkma, gün faşizme karşı mücadele etme günü. Burada bir eylem duyurusu yapmak istiyorum. Ayın 19'unda, 19 Ocak'ta Yunanistan elçiliğinin önünde bir gösteri olacak. Yunanistan'daki gelişen faşizme karşı. Orada Kürt halkının temsilcilerinin de yer alması, pankartlarıyla yer alması önemli diyoruz.
Just in conclusion, however many martyrs they create, victory will be ours. Freedom for Ocalan, victory to the Kurds.
Ne kadar katliam yaparlarsa yapsınlar, zafer bizim olacak. Kürdistan'a ve Öcalan'a özgürlük.